right. Good afternoon, Mr. Inquine. I'm Michael.
Hi.
I'm a student physical therapist.
Hi, you can call me Helga.
Okay.
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you. Go ahead and have a seat there. Great. So, Helga, I see on my form that you were referred by your orthopedic surgeon, Dr. Brown, for a right hamstring strain and pain. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's right. I don't want to have surgery for it.
I can absolutely understand why you'd want to avoid having surgery. Have you ever been to physical therapy before?
No, I haven't, but my friend went and she said it was really painful, and I'm just scared that you're gonna hurt my leg, and I don't know if I can do this. I had an appointment 2 weeks ago, but I canceled it because I just wasn't ready.
Well, I'm terribly sorry that your friend had a bad experience with physical therapy. I'm going to be very gentle today. And right now we're just gonna go through the history, so I don't even have to touch your leg currently. But is there anything I can do to help calm your nerves or make you feel a little bit more at ease here?
Not that I can think of. I really don't want you to hurt me.
Well, I will do my best to make you as comfortable as I possibly can. So the way this works is I'm going to start off by verifying some of your information that I have here on your form. And I'm going to ask you a few questions to get to know you a little bit better. I'll be taking some notes to help me remember. So if you have any questions or concerns at all, feel free to let me know and I would be very happy to clarify for you, okay?
Okay, that sounds good.
All right, so let's get started. So the form you filled out here says that you are 24 years old, is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. And your birthday is March 21st, correct?
Yes,
okay.
March 21st.
All right, so what do you do for a living?
I'm a dancer at SeaWorld.
Oh, very cool. What does that sort of job entail?
I'm in a chipmunk costume and I dance during animal performances and concerts. I've been working there for about 2 years now and I just got promoted to train the new dancers.
Wow. All right. Well, that's very cool. Congratulations on your promotion. Is that chipmunk costume heavy?
Yeah, it's really heavy. I'm so tired after work.
Okay. Yeah, I would be too. Can you estimate about how many days, about how many hours you work per day, or per week, I'm sorry.
Per week? Well, I dance about 20 hours per week, and then like the rest of my time is spent training other dancers.
Okay. And about how many days a week do you work?
I work 5 days a week.
Okay. How has your injury impacted your ability to do your job?
Well, I haven't been working the past 4 weeks since the injury happened. It just hurts too much to dance, and I can't really do anything with those crutches.
I'm very sorry to hear that. That must be very frustrating. I'm hoping that we can get you back to work soon.
Thanks. I'd really appreciate it. It just hurts so much, and I don't want it to hurt anymore.
I can understand that. Can you tell me what exercise you were doing prior to this injury?
Prior to this, I started a running program like 8 months ago.
Okay.
But I was really good at sticking to it, but since I got hurt, I haven't been able to.
Well, that's great that you were exercising, and I'm glad to hear it so that we can get you back to getting back to running.
Thanks. I'm really nervous that this is gonna just hurt me more.
Gonna try to make it so that you're as comfortable as possible. So besides working and exercising, what other activities would you say you're involved in?
Besides working and exercising, I like to get together with some of my SeaWorld friends and go out for an occasional happy hour. And, I have a bit of a green thumb too. I really like gardening.
Oh, cool. Does that require a lot of bending, sitting, standing?
It's mostly standing. I like to hang plants around my house, and I mean, it's really just a hobby. Like, I probably only do it 5 hours a week.
All right, that was gonna be my next question. Speaking of your house, do you live in an apartment or do you actually live in a house?
I live in a house.
Okay.
But it's a single story house, no stairs or anything.
Oh, well, that's good in your situation. Do you live alone or do you have roommates?
Oh, I live by myself.
Okay. So let's get to what's bringing you into physical therapy.
So about a month ago, I was standing on a pretty tall flower pot because I was hanging some plants, and I started falling, and I saw that my papillon, my little baby papillon, was right underneath me, and so I stuck out my leg and landed on my heel, and when I did, I just felt like a tear sensation in the back of my leg.
Oh, well, that had to have really hurt, but I'm glad you didn't step on your dog, but I'm sorry about your leg. Can you show me exactly where on your body you're experiencing pain?
Yeah, it's just right there.
So is it just right here?
Yeah.
Okay. So did you have any pain in that area prior to falling?
No, not prior to falling.
Okay. Besides the back of your leg, is there any other part of you that's hurting at all?
No.
So just to recap, you don't have pain in the hip, you don't have pain in the knee, you don't have pain in the ankle?
No. Only in the back of my leg.
Okay. So how would you describe this pain?
Describe it? It feels kind of sharp when I do feel it.
Okay. Would you say the pain is closer to the surface, or is it more deep inside your body?
Probably closer to the surface.
And is the pain constant, or does it come and go?
It comes and goes.
Do you experience any numbness or tingling at all?
No.
Okay. So on a scale from 0 to 10, 0 is no pain at all, and 10 being the most awful pain you can ever imagine. What number would you give your pain currently?
Right now it's probably about a 1.
Okay. At its worst, what number would you give it?
Probably like a 6.
Okay. And at its best, what number would you give it?
At its best, I don't even really feel it, so probably a 0.
Okay, good. Are there any other areas of pain that you're concerned about?
No, just my leg.
All right, so what type of activities make your leg pain worse than what it is?
It really starts hurting if I walk like for 2 minutes or more, and then dancing really hurts it.
Okay, how much is your leg pain affecting your daily life?
Since I can't walk for like more than 2 minutes, it basically affects like anything involved with walking, and I definitely can't do my job.
Oh yeah, I can understand that. So what activities and positions kind of help make it feel better?
Rest and just taking my medication seems to help. I ice it sometimes too.
Okay. That seems to help.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. About how long does it take for the pain to go away once you do these activities?
It doesn't take too long, like maybe a few minutes or so.
Okay, good. How does your leg feel in the morning? Is it painful?
I don't really feel it in the morning. It's no pain.
Okay. How does it feel throughout the day?
Throughout the day, it starts to hurt like the more I move around.
Yep. And what does it feel like at night?
It feels better like once I'm able to be home and like rested. And
okay. Does your pain wake you up at night ever?
No.
No. Okay. Have you ever had any x-rays or MRIs done on this area?
Yeah, after the accident, I went to the ER and got a x-ray and an MRI done.
Oh, okay. Do you know what the results were?
Yeah, I have them right here, actually.
Oh. Perfect. Let me just take a look at this really quickly. All right, so it says right here that you had a second degree sprain, is that correct?
Yeah, that's what the doctor said.
Okay, I'm gonna move this right over here. Alright, so, also says here on your form that you were taking Mobic for this, is that correct? And are there any other medications that you're taking?
Yeah, that's right. I was just taking like what the doctor gave me. I think I'm about done with it.
Okay. Have you ever shared that like before?
Yes, I had a labral tear surgery. When I was 18, I was in a cheerleading accident.
Okay.
I don't have any other problems with my leg right
now. Okay, so that pain doesn't seem to affect you anymore?
No.
Okay. Well, that's really good to know then. So I also see that you circled that you have a history of anxiety. I do have to ask, are you currently seeing anyone for this?
Yeah, seeing a psychologist or a psychiatrist to help me with that, my anxiety.
Okay, good. I'm very glad to hear that. Also, I have a follow-up question for that. So a lot of times people will take supplements for anxiety, and I am just going to ask you if you've taken any supplements at all for your anxiety, such as like St. John's Wort or Kava, anything like that?
No.
Okay.
Not.
Sometimes people miss that on the medication part because you don't think of supplements as being medications. So just wanted to make sure. All right. And I also see that you are a non-smoker. Is that correct?
That's correct.
All right.
I'm not a smoker.
Okay. And you noted you drink. Do you mind telling me approximately how many drinks you have per week?
I don't have a lot of drinks per week. I'll go out with my friends to like a happy hour, and I don't know. I guess I'd say like 3 drinks a week.
Okay. Is there any other medical history or family history, anything like cancer, diabetes, anything I should be made aware of?
No.
Okay. All right, so throughout your time here, I'm gonna be providing you with a lot of different exercises and stretches. How would you like this information presented? We have handouts, we have videos I can show you, I can also demonstrate them to you. What way would you learn best how to do these?
I guess demonstrating them to me and maybe some handouts that I can take with me.
Yeah, we can absolutely do that. That's not a problem at all. So what are your goals for physical therapy?
My goals, I really just want to be able to get back to work and walk without my crutches. I'm just really nervous. I'm going to hurt myself trying or just hurt myself more in physical therapy.
Yeah, I understand your concern, but I promise I'm going to make you as comfortable as possible. We're really going to try to get you back doing what it is that you love, okay? So is there anything else that you're unable to do now that you would like to be able to do?
Not that I can think of.
Okay. Well, thank you for all this information. Do you have any other questions or concerns at all?
Not at the moment.